Here we have a negative Q naught, and here we have a negative 4 Q naught. And this separation is given by L. And you can clearly see this the force between each other, well, it's a repulsive force, which in this direction. And now we have to place a third charge, so this two negative charge will be equilibriums. So we have we want to find out the magnitude and placement. You can see here for this thing to be equilibrium, the force on the both charge should be equals to the zero, I mean the net force. And so we have to balance out this force in this direction. And this is only possible if we place a positive Q charge between these two negative. And let's say the distance from here to here is x. And so the distance from here to here must be equals to this L minus X. Now for this F net to be equals to 0, we will have this each of us charge will experience two force. One force is due to the negative charge, so I write down this as a F negative, and this force is overcome by the second force, which is given by the positive charge. Let's say this is what we call the F positive. This 2 should be equals to 0, so this net charge is equal to 0. So from here you can see this F negative is equals to F positive. And first we consider the charge on this negative Q naught. You can see this is due to the negative charge is given by this separation distance L. This is L squared, and this is equals to this F positive. F positive is given by this Q over 4 pi epsilon. This distance is what we call the x. Now here we can cancel out this part and cancel out this part. This q then is given by this x squared l squared multiplied with this and now we consider the force acting on this negative 4 Q naught. F negative is the same, and F positive is given by this Q, negative 4 Q naught. Multiply with this Q positive, which now you can see here the separation from this positive charge to this negative 4 Q naught is given by L minus X M squared. Right. Now again we can cancel out the 4 pi epsilon, and this negative 4 Q naught. And from here, you can see this Q is given by this L negative X square over this L square and Q naught. And you can see these two equations, let's say this is 1 and this is 2, and this can be equal because the Q is the same. So from this 1 equals to the equation 2. Now this Q naught can be cancelled out, and this L square can be cancelled out. And what we left is 4 x square equals to the square. And now we can square root the both sides. We get a 2x is equals to the L minus x. Now you can see this is given by 3x is equals to L and x is equals to L over 3. And this is the placement where we put the positive charge. Now we still have to find out this magnitude of this Q, which is given by this formula, and we substitute this x equals L over 3 inside the formula 1 here. So we will get L over 3, this is a square, this is L square, and this is 4Q naught. And you can see this L square can be cancelled out. If we do, finally we get this Q is equals to 4 over 9 because the square here, remember the square, this is a Q naught. And this is the answer for the magnitude. So this is the answer for this question.